Now that we have the primary contents of our layout in place, we can add some additional information zones. The first one commonly used is a local weather feed, either for current information or a forecast. The weather forecast zone can be either vertical or horizontal. I think a horizontal forecast would fit our layout well, so let's add that zone. Just drag it to the canvas, move it into position, and resize as desired. To assign your local information to this zone, right-click and select Zone Properties. The background color can be changed from the default teal to any color you desire. Click OK to apply the change. Go back to the Zone Properties and enter your city and state text. This is text information for display only, so you can enter whatever you like here. Then enter your zip code. The actual weather information displayed is based on your zip code, so you must enter that accurately. Click OK when finished. Please note that in the Layout Design application, current or forecasted weather data will not be displayed on your screen. The true weather feed will only display when your media player is running and showing your layout. Another popular zone for dynamic signage is a news or entertainment service called an RSS feed, which displays condensed updates of current information. All that's needed is the URL address for your desired feed. To add an RSS zone, drag it to your canvas, move it into position, and resize as needed. As with all other zones, it can be modified by right-clicking and selecting which properties you'd like to modify. Let's start with the background properties to make it fit with our layout style. For this zone, rather than using a solid color or image, let's try a gradient. I'd like to use colors similar to the greens in the LobbyCaster logo. By selecting a darker green for the top gradient color and a lighter green for the bottom, we can get fairly close. Let's also add a thin border and a slight corner radius. Close the Background Properties window to continue. Now let's right-click and go to Zone Properties to add the URL address and assign which fields to display. Our URL here is for a generic entertainment feed. Options at the right include the duration for which each feed item is displayed, a custom main title for the zone, the maximum number of characters to display, the feed update interval, text color, and margin size. The default settings will work fine for our smaller zone here. At the left is a list of options for which fields to be displayed from the feed. In a smaller zone, it's easy for the fields to compete for space and overlap, making it more or less unreadable. For our needs here, just the item and description text will suffice, so I'll select the first option. Click OK to apply the changes. The last step is to right-click and select Text Properties. You can apply different settings for each text item in the zone. In our example, for the item title and item description. Select the text item you want to change from the list at the top, then choose a font, style, size, color, and alignment. Repeat for the other text items as needed. Close the properties window to complete the zone setup. Our layout is nearly complete, but we have just enough room at the bottom for another useful dynamic tool, a text scroller zone. A text scroller zone does just what its name implies. It scrolls a single line of text across the zone area. To add one to your layout, drag it to your canvas, move it into position, and resize as desired. I'd like ours to scroll all the way across the bottom of the screen from right to left. As with the other zones we've looked at, right-click and select Background Properties to change the appearance. The background can be set to a solid color, gradient, or image. You also have options for border and corner radius. I'd like our scrolling text to have a transparent background, so I'll select the transparent swatch in the solid color menu. We can right-click again to set the text properties. For this text, I'll change the color to white, choose an italic style, and adjust the size to fill the zone height. To enter the text you'd like to display, double-click on the zone, select the existing text, and replace with the text you like. The text can be longer than what might fit on the screen. It will all be visible as it scrolls in the display. Right-click one last time to edit the zone properties. Here, you can reverse the scroll direction if desired, and adjust the scrolling speed. However, it's recommended to use the default settings. You also have the option here to use an RSS feed instead of your entered text. Just enter the URL address. Click OK to apply any changes.